welcome. Thank you. So just a little preamble. It's a short class, so I'm going to try and start on time, and then I think the time will just go really fast. But I found a few things in life that regularly and reliably alter the consciousness. Meditation is one, you know, for sure. Being childlike or being around like a toddler or child can do it, but yeah, that's also stressful because they're kids, so like, has the downsides. Yeah, like I'm gonna drop it. They're gonna get into some. And poetry. Right, to have poetry read to you, to read poetry aloud, and participate in it, to certainly to create it, can shift your state. And there's no real negative side effects. There's other things you can take in that will shift your state, you know. And so I'll often, right after I meditate, or read before I meditate, or very similar mind states, you know, softened, wonder-filled, gentled. And so the idea with this is to help to create a state of meditativeness or meditative support. So if you brought a poem to read, we'll see if we remember, and we'll invite you to read, just to kind of shift which poem we hear and whose voice we hear, but you don't need to. It's not about performance or open mic kind of style. I've kind of written this sort of an order of poems that can sort of model and like an armature help with the practice of meditation. But it isn't that I picked the best poems, right? I picked a few so I'd have something to share. When I do my own practice, I'll flip and read, and I'm not that, not that. Oh, that kind of brought me somewhere. That shifted something. I'm thinking lyrically. It feels like the mind turns from a bowl to a colander, and the struggles of the being flow out, but the being retains what you'd like it to retain, right? Health, connection, community, contentedness, presence, with these kind of altered states. So just a bit of preamble, so you gotta know why we're doing it. So I think I'm gonna read one, and we're just gonna sit, since we're sat. This is a Howard Nemerov called Threshold. When in still air and still in summertime, a leaf has had enough of this, it seems to make up its mind to go. Fine as a sage, it's drifting in detachment down the road. still air and still in summertime. A leaf has had enough of this. It seems to make up its mind to go. Fine as a sage, it's drifting in detachment down the road. So, from Danna Faulds, settle in the here and now. Reach down into the center where the world is not spinning and drink this holy peace. Feel relief flood into every cell. Nothing to do. Nothing to be but what you are already. Nothing to receive but what flows effortlessly from the mystery into form. Nothing to run from or run toward. Just this breath. Awareness, knowing itself as embodiment. Just this breath. Awareness, waking up to truth. not spinning, and drink this holy peace. Feel relief flood into every cell. Nothing to do, nothing to be, but what you are already. Nothing to receive, but what flows effortlessly from the mystery into form. Nothing to run from or run toward. Just this breath, awareness, knowing itself as embodiment. Just this breath, awareness, waking up to truth. Anybody like to read a poem? Don't need to. You can do it next time too if you didn't want to or have one.
I'll do it next time.
Okay, great.
I'm liking your poems
sure, a favorite, very brief. This is called In Kyoto by Basho. In Kyoto, hearing the cuckoo, I long for Kyoto. Kyoto, hearing the cuckoo, I long for Kyoto. This is Transition Period by Julia Blovelt McGrain. If fashioned for some encounter, impelling but obscure, apprenticed to the future we wonder and endure. We suffer strange compulsion. Our talents, many skilled, would burn upon an altar we have not wit to build. Fashioned for some encounter, impelling but obscure, apprenticed to the future we wonder and endure. We suffer strange compulsion, our talents, many skilled, would burn upon an altar we have not wit to build. So in summation, I think that a lot of people think that meditation is harder than it may be, and I also think that I have found that many people often, regularly, consistently, foreverly think that meditation is a lonely practice without support. I have to do this all by myself, sit here, do the thing for a long time, very well and all that. We probably lose sight of the idea that, you know, there are sangha and other supports, like poetry. Like, hey, this can help me get there. Like, read a little poetry and then sit, or sit until you want to read a little poetry, or, you know, kind of help you shift into that mindset. And, you know, it can be done with music or a walk in nature, or spending time with kids, or a couple of these things. But it doesn't have to be just time to meditate. There's a pillow staring back angrily at me, and I have to get over there and do the thing. Just, you know, hear a poet read some words for a little bit and see if it doesn't help alter. alter you from the mundane. Might be a little access road into that power of the place of that poetry. So thank you for joining me.